So hi Jatin sir, welcome to Eastern Eye.
Pleasure is mine.
So I think it's kind of a great opportunity for me to take an interview of a legend music composer like you. So thank you so much for being with us.
My pleasure. Always there for you.
So first of all, sir, I have to congratulate you for 20 years of Mohabbate and 25 years of DDLJ.
Yes. Actually, I think we all deserve, congratulations, whoever has worked for this film. It's really a milestone.
I have to say that though it has been 25 years and 20 years of both the films, but the songs are still, even this generation love this song. That was the, I would say the power of the composition and the singers of that era. So I think I would like to start this interview by asking you this question, that do you feel that the movies that came in 90s and early 2000, the songs, the longevity of those songs are more than what the songs are currently? Do you feel that way?
See, to be very honest, there are few composers who do good job. It's not that music is absolutely evaporated and there is nobody to hold the candle of the senior composer. It's nothing like that. But yes, the situations in the film have changed. Earlier, we used to have lip-sync songs. Actors used to lip-sync them. And it used to make so much of sense. The script writing today has changed and it has affected the music. See, our film industry is known for its music. Like Chinese films are known for karate, Hollywood films are known for their grandeur, the bigness of the graphics and everything. The same way, Indian films were known for its music. And we are missing that. We have to get back to that timeless music and good lyrics and good rendering and good arrangement. Good locations, all those things are missing, to tell you the truth.
Right. So, sir, of course, I have been, when a movie completes a 25 years or a 20 years, we always see there is this kind of unknown facts that we hear. And recently I read that, Mehndi Laga Ke Rakhna was not supposed to be a part of DDLJ and it was supposed to be a part of any other film. So, is that true?
I don't know, where did you get this, who told you, but as far as I know, we had the sitting and we sang this song. And of course, Aditya Chopra asked us when he came to us, that do you all have that song? We said, yes, we have. And it was, luckily it was used in DDLJ and it was one of the biggest hit of all time.
I think right now also, there's not even any single Indian wedding that goes without Mehndi Laga Ke Rakhna.
Exactly, and there is not a single marriage band, yeah, which doesn't play this song.
True.
We will be surprised to know that even when there is a Kannada marriage or marriage of Malayalam, they play this song.
So, sir, nowadays it has become a trend, and I won't be wrong if I say that at least one film has a recreated version of a song, of an old classic. What's your take on it? And, will you be okay if any of your old classic songs are recreated?
To be very, very honest, such legendary songs, such timeless music has to be created some way or the other. People will not, they know because this song is there in the roots of every Indian. Every Indian, connects with this song. They know this song so well. So if you recreate, you have got a very easier way to go and reach to the people. That is the only way. Because the song is so popular. Even you make mistakes, even you do something wrong to it, people will at least talk about it. That is the reason they do it. But I still prefer original. Original is original. Original has a craftsmanship and it is thoughtfully done. It is done with so much of intelligent minds working together.
So, sir, you know, also nowadays, compositions in movies are changing. I mean, you know, earlier we used to have just one composer. We used to compose all the songs for a film. But now it's like there are, you know, sometimes if there are seven songs, there are seven different composers for in a movie. So, are you okay to work in such zone? Or you would prefer that if you do a film, it should be only your film?
I think it also, you know, it has a two way of looking at it. One way is whether composers are enough ready to handle one whole album. Suppose if one composer has the capacity of giving seven great songs, why will somebody go? That is one thing. Secondly, maybe the directors who are wanting to take the music are not well equipped enough to dig somebody and get the music out. Earlier there was nothing like that, ke we have to go to some other composer for second song. So they used to sit there, but they used to sit and they used to spend time till the time the tune and everything is not correct. That patience is not there. Now what happens, ke you get one good song from one composer and somebody else comes to your house and say, I have this song, please take this, is a hit song, and you really like it. So you don't want to work hard and go to that same composer original, sit there for hours, get the second tune right. You don't want to do that. You want instant composition. That is the reason it is happening.
So sir, for the last question for this interaction to you would be, when are we again listening to your compositions in Bollywood films?
Very soon, God willing.
Thank you so much, sir. I think this was really an amazing musical interaction that I had with you. And thank you so much for being with us.
You have a lot of blessing from my end. Keep the good work. You are so young and you are so much on the right track. God bless you so much and take care of yourself.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Bye. Take care.
Good night.